DFA Secretary Teddy Loxin Jr. Secretary Teddy, good morning. We are back. Retired Senior Associate Justice Antonio Carpio just a few days ago warned about China possibly putting up naval bases in the Scarborough Shoal. Do you have the same concern? And if China does, what will the Philippines do about that? Will we take action?
I believe they already have the reef, and they have reclaimed around it, they have reclaimed it, and they have weaponized it. And in all that time, of course, our great ally did absolutely nothing. I must tell you that it's not just indifference, it's also some military strategy that goes. I went to SINCPAC with Secretary Cayetano, and we were there, we were given a brief, and I kept insisting, well, they were describing radius of projection of Chinese power. And I kept pointing at the reef that they had seized and they had reclaimed partially with our own sand, would you believe? Just like us to make money out of losing our own territory. But anyway, and I said, what about that? And the guy says, you're interfering with my presentation, and kept talking about the projection of Chinese power. And I said, what about that? And he turned and he said, in the first 30 minutes of conflict, we'll send a missile there. And that missile is a heat missile. And we're going to turn that sand into a Coca-Cola bottle. So that's the response to it. Meanwhile, what else have we done? Well, thanks to Tony Carpio, thanks to Noynoy Aquino, and the Secretary Del Rosario, we won that case. And I'm 100% grateful to them, as the country should be, for winning that case. Okay. We have the law on our side. However, this is important. I told my people here, since all we have is the law, and at that time, the United States was very wary about committing its military resources to this region. And I think they're not so keen about it even now. I said, we must be absolutely precise in our legal responses, because all we have is the law. We don't have power.
Okay, but Secretary, you just spoke about in detail that you said there's already presence in Scarborough Shoal, but Carpio talked about a building an air defense system. That air defense identification zone. Clearly, it is not yet built.
Well, I don't know. He seems to know it better than anybody else. I'm going to ask the Americans. I don't know where Carpio is getting that information, but assuming they can.
Yes,
I can
assuming. Imagine. In terms of foreign policy, where does the Philippines stand?
But one thing is sure. They already have an air a landing strip for fighter jets. They have almost everything on that, but it is virtually an unsinkable aircraft carrier, but the Americans assure me they can erase it in the first 30 minutes of conflict. So anyway, it's there. It's a weapons, we call that in the business an ordnance platform. It's a weapons platform, and it's complete.
Yeah, but I think, Secretary, the overall question is, when it comes to foreign policy with China, what is the stand of the Philippine government when it comes to Chinese expansion? In the Philippine Sea, in parts of the South China Sea, do you have a stand? I mean, because if it's
unless Carpio has lost his hearing, I have been giving very strong responses to that. Diplomatic notes have been fired. I was not very happy with diplomatic notes, but at that time I was not yet Secretary of Foreign Affairs. So I would appear in the United Nations and blast China. That's what I would do. And what do we do after that? We just have to keep doing this. And you know why we need to do that? Although I myself was against what I called throwing paper at a brick wall. I was told by my experts here, you know, sir, the diplomatic protests will not get it back. And the Chinese they don't always answer it in point. But the point is, every time we file a diplomatic protest, we assert again and again what we want in the Hague Tribunal.
Now, that's what you do. Okay. Justice Carpio described the Philippine government's relationship with China as a relationship of appeasement at the cost of our sovereignty. Do you agree?
No. To begin with, you're looking at the opposite of appeasement right now.
Describe that. You said you're looking at the opposite. How?
Every transgression and incursion made by the Chinese, or even just the suspicion of it, is immediately reported to me by General Esperon, and we craft a diplomatic note and fire it off. Every single one without fail. Now, more than that, there was one thing that I did suggest to President Noynoy when he was president. Do you really want to test who owns that? I suggest you get on a boat. I think it's the presidential yacht, and you sail towards the Chinese.
Yes, but we're talking about this administration.
Let's see where it goes.
Yes, but this administration has not issued a statement regarding these incursions. Yes, you've issued notes, but has it taken a strong...
I'm afraid he's wrong. He's misinformed, and I must say he's deliberately misinformed, because I told you when we last spoke, the president brings this up himself with President Xi. Mm. Sometimes it's not so well received. There was one time when he brought it up, and I said, perhaps you shouldn't bring it up at this moment. He did. The reception was very cold.
Okay.
But he does bring it up straight to presidency. And anyone who says otherwise, making things up.
Okay. We don't have enough time, but I want to ask you the latest on the joint oil exploration. What stage are we in, Secretary, with that?
The joint exploration, it's still there. There were talks. On the Chinese side, they're still, and the Philippine side, they're still talking about the meaning of this and that term. And I said, on both sides, I said, I'm not going to hold any more meetings, because I already put out the MOU. It's already there. It was signed by the Foreign Minister Wang Yi in an act of supreme trust. He signed it virtually almost unread. I said, no, it's there. And that will govern the development of oil and gas in what we call disputed areas. Areas they say is theirs, areas we insist is ours, and for which we have the Hague Tribunal decision. Mm-hmm.
So is China open to that? You've said they haven't read it. Have they?
No. When I present, they've read it like hell now, but when I presented it, I saw it as such a tremendous act of trust on the part Foreign Minister, I presented it to him and he signed it.
Okay.
And because he signed it, that way I then turned and he asked, would you consider also the Belt and Road memorandum so that we join the Belt and Road? And I said, because I had also crafted an MOU on the Belt and Road, and he had looked at it, but he wasn't really sure what I'd said there. And you know what I said? No, I will not consider it. I will sign it right here. That's how you return an act of trust by the Chinese. You do it by the Filipinos.
Okay. Secretary, I don't mean to interrupt you. You did say that you've been given strong diplomatic responses to Chinese incursions. How many diplomatic protests have you fired since the start of 2016?
I forgot that.
Would you
number.
Know?
No, I would know. In fact, I gave it out to the Senate, but I forgot it already. But every single incident has been responded to, except one. When I had just taken over, and ABS-CBN had a kind of vague picture of what might have been Chinese activity in an 8 hours, and I believe my answer to ABS-CBN correspondent was, you know, your bosses are very rich, and they have their own private jets. Why don't they lend you that so we can get a clearer picture of what you're asking me to comment on? No, silence.
All right, so... Okay, so you don't know right now just how many you've already fired since the start of 2016. Okay. All right.